Hello children, welcome back to the chemistry session. In previous session we have seen line spectrum of hydrogen atom. In today's session we are going to talk about Bohr's model for hydrogen atom or postulates of Bohr's theory. Let us start today's session children. Bohr's model of an atom. Or we can say that postulates of Bohr's atomic model. Bohr's atomic model was based on the Planck's quantum theory of radiation, that is E is equal to H nu children. According to the quantum theory of radiation, the energy of electromagnetic radiation is directly proportional to the frequency of the radiation. That is called Planck's quantum theory of radiation. So Niels Bohr considered Planck's quantum theory of radiation. So based on that, Niels Bohr explained the model of an atom, that means atomic model of an atom. So Niels Bohr considered that atomic nucleus is the center of an atom. This atomic nucleus contains nucleons. Nucleons means protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons are called nucleons because protons and neutrons are present in the nucleus. That's why they are called nucleons. According to the Bohr's theory, suppose this is an atom and it is the center of the atom. The center of the atom is called nucleus. The size of the nucleus is small compared to that of size of the atom. This atomic nucleus contains protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons. Protons have positive charge and neutrons no charge. That's why charge of the nucleus is positive. That's why nucleus charge is positive. So Bohr explained that atomic nucleus contains protons and neutrons, so that they are called nucleons. And there are infinite number of shells. There are infinite number of shells present around the center of the atom. Not one or two shells, there are infinite number of shells. There are n number of shells, are infinite number of shells revolve around the nucleus. And these shells are called stationary orbits or stationary shells. These are called stationary orbits or stationary shells, and they are denoted by KLMN. We have learned in 9th class children. They are denoted by KLMN or 1, 2, 3, 4 children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Except there are n number of cells. There are n number of cells present around the center of the atom, that is called nucleus. And these are called stationary orbit or stationary shells. Why do we call them so? This is because these shells are the path of electrons. That means electrons revolve in these shells. When the electron revolves in these shells, the energy of the electron is constant. The electron never loses energy when the electron revolve in these circular orbits or circular shells. And these shells as well as orbits have fixed amount of energy as well as radius. That means when the electron is revolving in these shells, the energy of the each shell as well as radius of the shell is confined. We can calculate the radius of the each orbit as well as energy of the each orbit. That's why when the electron is revolving in these shells, the energy of the electron is constant. So that these shells are called stationary orbits or stationary shells. And when the electron absorbs energy from the surrounding, the electron may not be present at the lower energy level. Suppose the electron is present at the first energy level. That is, n value is 1. And when the electron gets energy from the surroundings, the electron transfer from the lower energy level to the higher energy level. Initially, electron in ground state. When the electron absorbs energy from the surroundings, it gets excited to the lower level to the higher energy level. This is called absorption. So absorption means the transfer of electron from lower energy level to the next higher energy level. Next, similarly, when the electron present at the higher energy level, that may not be stable for a long time. So it can come to the lower energy levels. That means electron is present here. This electron comes down to the lower energy levels. During this path, it give up radiation. This is called emission. So during this journey, it give up radiation. This is called emission. So absorption means energy absorbed by the electron from the surroundings and travel to the next higher energy levels. This is called absorption. And emission means electron jump from higher level to the lower level. It gives up radiation is called as emission. So together absorption and emission is called as transition. Electron transition cycle. Together absorption and emission is called as transition. Here angular momentum of an electron. What do you mean by angular momentum? Because according to the Bohr's, Niels Bohr, electron revolving around the nucleus in circular path. Suppose electron is present here. This is position of electron and this is the nucleus. So electron is revolving around the nucleus in circular path. And we know that this electron possesses a mass, where m is the mass of the electron. And the electron is moving with the velocity, that is called v. V is the velocity of the electron. And there is some distance between the center of the nucleus from the orbit. Suppose this is the position of the electron and this is the center of the electron. And the distance between the center of the electron from the orbit is denoted by small r. This is called radius of the orbit. That means angular momentum of an electron is mvr. Angular momentum of an electron is mvr. It is the product of mass and velocity and acceleration and radiation is equal to integral multiple of h by 2 pi. Angular momentum of an electron mvr is equal to integral multiple n into h by 2 pi. Here angular momentum of an electron is quantized. Angular momentum here, angular momentum is quantized. What does what quantized represents? Quantized means finite amount of energy. That means suppose electron is revolving in first orbit. If the electron is revolving in first orbit, then angular momentum of first orbit is h by 2 pi. Because n value is 1 for first orbit. That's why 1 h by 2 pi is the angular momentum of first electron. Suppose electron is revolving in second orbit. Then angular momentum of electron in second orbit is 2 h by 2 pi. So when the electron is revolving in second orbit, its angular momentum is 2 h by 2 pi. We can calculate the value when the electron is revolving in second orbit. Similarly, remaining orbits 3 h by 2 pi, 4 h by 2 pi, 5 h by 2 pi, and so on. So electron is revolving in those circular orbits whose angular momentum is equal to the integral multiple of h by 2 pi. That means, suppose if the electron is moving in first orbit, then its angular momentum is 1 h by 2 pi. Or if the electron is revolving in third orbit, its angular momentum should be 3 h by 2 pi. That means, angular momentum of an electron is quantized. And Niels Bohr also explained maximum capacity of each orbit. Niels Bohr also explained maximum capacity of each orbit. We have given the formula 2n square. By 2n square formula, we can find out the maximum capacity of each orbit. That means number of electrons can be present in each shell cylinder. These are called stationary orbits or shells. Suppose shell. First shell is K shell. And the n value is, what is n value for K shell? N value is 1 for K shell. Then number of electrons. Number of electrons are capacity of first shell is 2 into 1 square. That is 2 electrons. So 2 electrons are present in A shell. Next, L shell. L shell. L shell means second shell. N value is 2. The maximum capacity of second shell is 2 into 2 square. That is equal to 8 electrons. So maximum capacity of second shell is, a second orbit is 8 electrons. Next, M shell. N value 3 for M shell. KLM. And maximum capacity 2 into 3 square is equal to 18 electrons. Next, N shell. N shell, N value is 4. Capacity of the N shell is 2 into 4 square is equal to 32 electrons. So by 2n square formula, we can find out maximum capacity of each orbit. For K shell, maximum capacity is 2 electrons. For L shell, 8 electrons. M shell, 18 electrons. And N shell, 32 electrons. So Niels Bohr also calculated radius of each orbit. And the radius of first orbit divided by R1, second R2, third R3, and so on. These are the radius of different orbits as well as energies of the different orbits. E1, E2, E3. E1 refers energy of the first orbit. E2 energy of the second orbit. E3 energy of the third orbit. And so on so forth. And he explained the energy gap or the energy difference between two orbits. That is equal to delta E. He explained that energy difference between the two energy levels is equal to delta E. Delta E is equal to E2 minus E1. Where E2 is energy of higher energy level and E1 is energy of lower energy level. This energy difference between the two energy levels is equal to the frequency of radiation, that means delta E is equal to h nu. Because from Planck's quantum theory of radiation, E is equal to h nu. Because Niels Bohr considered Planck's quantum theory of radiation. From Planck's quantum theory of radiation, E is equal to h nu. Then delta E is equal to delta h nu shall be. So E2 minus E1. E2 minus E1. E2 means energy of higher energy level and E1 is energy of lower energy level. These are the postulates of Bohr's atomic model. Bohr's atomic model was based on Planck's quantum theory of radiation children. Or it is also called as quantum mechanical model of an atom. So Niels Bohr explained that he considered that atomic nucleus contains nucleons. Nucleons means protons and neutrons are called nucleons. Protons have positive charge, neutrons no charge. That's why the charge of the nucleus is positive. And the size of the nucleus is small to that of size of the atom. And there are n number of circular orbits revolve around the nucleus. There are n number of shells revolve around the nucleus, and these shells are called stationary orbits or stationary shells. This is because these shells have finite radius and energy. That's why they are called stationary orbits. Whenever the electron revolving in these shells, the energy of the electron is constant. And we explained that absorption and emission also. Absorption means the phenomena of electron travel from lower energy level to higher energy level by absorbing energy. Emission means traveling from higher level to lower level by give up radiation. It's called emission. And he also explained that angular momentum of an electron. Angular momentum of an electron is quantized. That means whenever the electron revolving around the nucleus in the circular orbit, its value is quantized. That means it's the integral multiple of h by 2 pi. That is h by 2 pi, 2h by 2 pi, 3h by 2 pi, 4h by 2 pi, etc. These are angular momentum values for electron is moving in different orbits. And Niels Bohr also explained maximum capacity of each orbit or each shell. And these shells are denoted by K, L, M, N or 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And the capacity of each shell is 2. By 2n square formula, we can find out capacity of each shell. K shell 2, L shell 8, M shell 18, N shell 13. So these are the postulates of the Bohr's model of an atom. I hope you understand today's session, children. This is today's session. In next session, we will discuss about Bohr's explanation of hydrogen spectrum and limitations of Bohr's theory. We will meet in next session, children. Thank you.